In problem number 26, you are asked to find the slope of the line tangent to the curve at a certain point. So, for this problem, what you're required to remember is implicit differentiation. There's no way you can isolate x or y, and so we're going to have to use implicit differentiation. So let's first start with, what is the question asking us to find? The question is asking us to find dy dx at the point 3, 2. And like I said, what you need to do is use the implicit differentiation. We're going to take the derivative with respect to x of the left side, and of course of the right side. So we have the derivative with respect to x of 6 minus 2xy. So the derivative with respect to x of 3y squared is 6. Let's take a little bit longer. It is 3 times 2y times dy dx minus 4x and is equal to 0, the derivative with respect to x is equal to 0, minus 4, the derivative of 2xy, what you want to use is the product rule. Minus 2, the derivative of x is just equal to 1, so 2 times 1 times y. And then here is where a lot of people go wrong. That minus sign needs to be distributed. Let's stop over. I'm sorry about that. Minus 2, again, the derivative of x is 1, so minus 2. Times 1 times y, and then minus 2x times the derivative of y is just dy dx. We'll come back to this in a second. I don't want to go over the derivative of y squared. So a lot of people have trouble taking the derivative with respect to x of y squared. And I believe that if you realize that y is equal to f of x, it might be easier for you to take the derivative of 3y squared. And so if you rewrite that as the derivative with respect to x of 3 times f of x quantity squared, it might be easier for you to know that this is 3 times 2 f of x raised to the power of 1 times, we're going to use the chain rule, f prime of x. Rewriting this, this is 6, and then replacing f of x by 1, by y, y to the first is 1, so 6y times f prime of x dy dx. So that is why the derivative of 3y squared is 6y dy dx minus 4x is equal to negative 2y minus 2x dy dx. Let's quickly go over the derivative with respect to x of 2xy. D dx 2xy. I know it says negative 2xy. You can throw in the negative at the very end. Rewrite it. This is d dx of 2x times f of x. And now use the product rule. This is 2 times f of x plus 2x times f prime of x. So this is just 2y plus 2x dy dx. Do remember that all of this is actually negative, and if you distribute the negative, you get negative 2y minus 2x dy dx, which is what we have on the right side. Now, what you want to do right now, rather than go on and solve for dy dx, a shortcut is right now, replace your x by 3 and your y by 2. So right now, don't wait until later. You're just wasting time. Not only are you wasting time, you might even make an algebraic mistakes. So let's replace y by 2, so 6 times 2 dy dx minus 4 times 3 is equal to negative 2 times 2 minus 2 times 3 dy dx. Right now, this has become an algebra 1 problem, so 12 dy dx minus 12 is equal to negative 4 plus 6 dy dx. Yes, you can actually subtract 6 dy dx from both sides, minus 6 dy dx, and you can add 12 to both sides. Like I said, this is just algebra 1, but the variable looks scary. 12 dy dx, 6 dy dx is 6 dy dx. 6 dy dx is equal to negative 4 plus 12 is 8. Divide by 6 on both sides, and dy dx is equal to 4 over 3. So the slope of the tangent line is 4 over 3. That's all there is to question number 26. We now move on to question number 27. In question number 27, what we need to review is how to find the derivative of an inverse function. So let's start by saying, let g of x be equal to f inverse of x. What you should remember is that f inverse of x is equal to x. So this also means that f of g of x is equal to x. So what am I doing right now? I'm figuring out what is the derivative with respect to x of f inverse of x. So right now we take the derivative with respect to x on both sides. Make sure that you use the chain rule on the left side. So you have the derivative with respect to x of f of g of x is equal to the derivative with respect to x of x. This is f prime of g of x times g prime of x is equal to 1. So g prime of x is equal to 1 over f prime of g of x. Now that we have all this information, we're ready to figure out g prime of 2. G prime of 2 is equal to 1 over f prime of g of 2. We are told that g of 2 is equal to 1, so g prime of 2 is equal to 1 over f prime of 1. And to find f prime of 1, we have the following information. We are told that f of x is equal to x cubed plus x. F prime of x is 3x squared plus 1, and f prime of 1 is what I'm trying to find. It's just going to be 3 times 1 squared plus 1, so 4. So g prime of 2 is equal to 1 over f prime of 1. It is equal to 1 over 4. And that's the end of this question.